Praise the Lord. We are still reading from the book of Psalm 60, now verse number 5 to 12. I'll read verse 5, 10, 11, and 12. The Bible says, "Now rescue your beloved people, answer and save us by your power." Verse 10, "Have you rejected us, O God? Will you no longer march with our enemies? Oh, please help us against our enemies. For all human help is useless. With God's help, we will do mighty things, for he will trample down our enemies." The psalmist acknowledges that it is only God who is able or who can give us the ability to stand strong, just as he said in verse number 4, that he raises the banner of those who trust in him, those who fear him. It is only God who can rescue us. And no wonder in verse number 5 he says, "Now rescue your beloved people." Number 2, answer. And number 3, save us by your power. Rescue, answer, save us by your power. The power of God is what we need in our day-to-day endeavors. Because when the Lord is together with us, we are sure and we have this confidence that there is no power, there is no force, there is no attack that can overtake us. Verse number 10, he's still asking. Remember in verse 1, he was saying, you have rejected us, O God. Verse number 10, he's asking a question. Have you rejected us, O God? Another question. Will you no longer march with our enemies? Have you rejected us, O God? Verse 1, he says, "You have rejected us, O God, and broken our defenses." Verse 10, you know, he's saying, he's asking a question. Have you rejected us, O God? Will you no longer stand and contend with our enemies? And the psalmist is concerned that without your power, without your intervention, we cannot make it. And verse number 11, "Oh, please help us against our enemies, for all human help is useless." And even this day, as we read from the book of Psalm 60, verse 11, it is a key reminder to all of us that it is only the power of God, the hand of the Almighty, that can give us victory in any situation, in any kind of circumstance. And it is only God who can rescue us from the hands of our enemy. And one of the ways and the greatest ways that the Lord has demonstrated this powerful hand upon our lives is through the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has given us victory through the salvation that we have received in Jesus Christ. And this salvation has called us out of darkness into this marvelous light. This redemption is a key factor for us to acknowledge that we need the intervention of God, the powerful hand of God upon us. And the psalmist here is saying, "Oh, please help us against our enemies, for all human help is useless." All human help that we may tap is useless. And in verse number 12, he says, "With God's help," hallelujah, "with God's help, we will do mighty things, for he will trample down our foes." With God's help, we will do mighty things. I'm reading from the New Living Translation version. With God's help, we will do mighty things. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge that with God's help, there is nothing that can stand against us. There is nothing that is too hard for God to tackle. And again, with God's help, we will do mighty things. We will do mighty things in our families, in our ministries, in our businesses, in everything with God's help. Don't depend on your muscle. depend on the help that comes from the Lord and plead with God, just like the psalmist in verse number 11. Oh, please help us against our enemies, for all human help is useless. With God's help, we will do mighty things, for he will trample down our foes. Are you feeling as though you are left alone? You are struggling alone. I want to remind you, with God's help, you will do mighty things. With God's help, you rise again. Be strong and courageous. Allow God to rescue you, to save, to answer you, and to save you by his power. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Shalom.